So in today's lecture of EE352, which is power system, we'll discuss about the circuit breakers. So there are different types of circuit breakers used in electrical power system, as shown in the slide. That circuit breaker, the main bifurcation between it is the miniature circuit breaker, that is MCB, then molded case circuit breakers, that is MCCB. Then both circuit breakers now come to for low and medium voltage application. So this is a combination where we can bifurcate circuit breakers into two parts. Also, for according to the medium for arc extension, circuit breakers are divided like air brake circuit breaker, air blast circuit breaker, oil circuit breaker. Here, oil circuit breakers are two types of oil circuit breakers available: bulk oil circuit breaker and minimum oil circuit breaker. Then the next one is SF6 circuit breaker, that is known as sulfur hexafluoride circuit breaker and vacuum circuit breakers. Now we see here in brief that where these circuit breakers are applicable. So air circuit breakers are used air as a medium for arc extension. The name suggests that air is used as a medium for arc extension. In case of air blast circuit breaker, as the name suggests, pressurized air is used for arc extension. In oil circuit breaker, transformer oil as a dielectric medium is used for arc extension. In SF6 or sulfur hexafluoride circuit breaker, SF6 case is used for arc extension. And in vacuum circuit breaker, vacuum is used for arc extension. Now we come see one by one the circuit breaker. First is air circuit breaker and air blast circuit breaker. So this type of circuit breaker is those kinds of circuit breaker which operates in air at the atmospheric pressure. In case of air circuit breaker, after the development of oil circuit breaker, the medium voltage air circuit breaker is replaced by the oil circuit breaker. Now, if we see the principle of operation of air brake circuit breaker or air circuit breaker, the working principle of this breaker is different from other circuit breakers. The main aim of the circuit breaker is to prevent the re-establishment of arcing after current zero by creating a situation where the contact gap will withstand the system recovery voltage. Now the air circuit breaker does the same but in different manner. For interrupting arc, it creates an arc voltage in excess of supply voltage. The arc voltage is defined as the minimum voltage required maintaining the arc. This circuit breaker increases the arc voltage by mainly three different ways. Number one, it may increase arc voltage by cooling the arc plasma. As the temperature of arc plasma is decreased, the mobility of particle in arc plasma is reduced. Hence, more voltage gradient is required to maintain the arc. In second case, it may increase the arc voltage by lengthening the arc path. Lengthening the arc path. As the length of arc path increased, the resistance of path increased, and hence to maintain the same arc current, more voltage is required to be applied across the R path, that means R voltage is increased. And in third case, splitting up the arc into number of series arc, which also increases the arc voltage. So main purpose is to increase the arc voltage by three different ways. Now the types of air circuit breakers. There are plain air circuit breaker, are also known as air circuit breaker, and air blast circuit breaker, which we have seen in the last slide. Now the operation of air circuit breaker, the first objective is usually achieved by forcing the arc into contact as large as possible for insulating material. So every air circuit breaker is fitted with a chamber surrounding the contact. By this way you can easily understand, this is the fixed contact and that is the movable contact. As the relay sends signal to the circuit breaker, this contact will open and here the arc will produce. So we have to extinguish this arc and make a situation such that the arc will not re-establish. As the arc extinguishes, now the circuit is open. So the chamber is called the arc tube. The arc is driven into it. If inside the arc tube is suitably safe and if the arc can be made conform to the shape, the arc tube wall will help to achieve cooling. This type of arc tube should be made from some kind of refractory material and high temperature plastic reinforced with glass fiber and ceramic are preferably material for making this chamber. The second objective is the lengthening the arc path is achieved concurrently with the first objective. If the arc wall of arc tube is shaped in such a way that arc is not only forced into close proximity with it but also driven into a separate channel project on the arc tube wall, the lengthening of the arc path increases the arc resistance. And the third technique is achieved by using metal arc splitter inside the arc chamber. The main arc tube is divided into number of small components by metallic separation. So if the arc is produced here, by this way we are lengthening the arc, and once again here the arc is divided into different components. The metallic separation plates are actually the arc splitters, and each of the small component behaves as is medium individual mini arc tube. In this system, the initial arc is split into number of series arcs, which each of which have its own mini arc tube. So each of the split arc has its own cooling and lengthening effect due to its own mini arc tube, and hence individual split arc voltage becomes high. This collectively makes the overall arc voltage much higher than the system voltage. Now this was the principle of arc circuit breaker, air blast circuit breakers. Now we come to the diagram of the circuit breaker. here. This is the air circuit breaker. These are the arc tubes. These are the splitters. Main contact. These are the contact and this is arc contact. So here the arc will produce. You can see here. This the main contact and this is the runner or movable contact. At this time the contacts are closed. The circuit breaker is in closed position. As soon as the breaker opens, this opens, the arc which is produced here at this end, it will go like this and like this. So this is known as arc runner. This component is known as arc runner. As the name suggests, it increases the length of the arc. Now there are some type. So this type of air circuit breakers are used for the system voltage up to of 245 kV to 420 kV and also even for higher range. Especially where fast breaker operation is required, air blast circuit breaker has more specific advantage over oil circuit breakers. The advantages are there is no chance of fire hazard caused by oil in case of oil circuit breaker, as the contacts are submerged in oil and as the contacts were open, the arc will produce. So there will be a chance of fire hazard, but in case of air circuit breaker, the chances are zero. The breaking speed of circuit breaker is much higher during the operation of air blast circuit breaker. The arc quenching is much faster during operation of air blast circuit breaker, and the duration of arc is same for all values of small as well as high current interruption. So these are the advantages of air circuit breakers. As the duration of arc is smaller, so lesser amount of heat released from the arc to carry current contact, and the service life of contact becomes longer. The stability of the system can be well maintained as it depends on the speed of the operation of circuit breaker, and it requires much less maintenance as compared to the oil circuit breaker. But there are some disadvantages also. Number one, in order to have frequent operations, it is necessary to have sufficient high capacity air compressor, because for the air blast circuit breaker, the compressor must be having sufficient capacity. So if the operation are frequent, so the high pressure air will release. So it is necessary to have sufficient high capacity of compressor should be there. Frequent maintenance of compressor, associated air pipes and automatic control equipment is required. Due to high speed current interruption, there is a chance of high rate of rise of heavy striking voltage and current choking, and also a chance of air pressure leakage from the air by junction. So it is having advantages as well as some disadvantages. Now the circuit breaker can be subdivided into three different categories: axial blast air circuit breaker, axial blast with side moving contacts, and so this is the diagram of axial blast circuit breaker with side moving contacts. So this is the blast pipe, moving contacts, then exhaust to atmosphere, fixed contact, breaker terminal, probe, nozzle orifice, spring loading for moving contacts and going contacts. So in case of axial air blast circuit breaker with side moving contact, from here the blast air will come into the circuit breaker, and as the arc produced here, as contacts were open, the arc will produce this high pressure air, will take the energized particles here as well as arc to the atmosphere. So by this way the arc will extinguish. Now this is the principle of cross blast air circuit breaker. Here this is the air flow, fixed contact, moving contact, exhaust chamber, blast pipe, and the arc. As soon as the contacts were open, the fixed and moving contacts goes downward, arc will produce. At the same time air flow will come into the picture, and it takes the arc to this splitter, and so now by this way arc will be increased and the resistance of arc will higher, so it as the length increases, the resistance of arc increases, and so the arc will extinguish soon. So this is the principle of cross blast air circuit breaker. Now when next one is minimum oil circuit breaker. So this type of circuit breaker utilize oil as an interrupting medium. However, unlike bulk oil circuit breaker, a minimum oil circuit breaker places the interrupting unit in insulating chamber at live potential. The insulating oil is available only in interrupting chamber. The feature of designing minimum oil circuit breaker is to reduce the requirement of oil, and hence these breakers are called minimum oil circuit breaker. So as the volume of the oil is, in bulk oil circuit breaker is huge, the chances of fire hazard in bulk oil circuit breaker are more. for avoiding unwanted fire hazard in the system. One important development in the design of oil circuit breaker has been introduced, where use of oil in the circuit breaker is much less than the bulk oil circuit breaker. It has been decided that the oil in the circuit breaker should only be used for arc quenching medium and not as the insulating medium. So then the concept of minimum oil circuit breaker comes. In this type of circuit breaker, the arc interrupting device is enclosed in the tank of insulating medium, which as a whole is at live potential of the system. This chamber is called arcing chamber or interrupting chamber, interrupting pod. The gas pressure developed in arcing chamber depends upon the current to be interrupted. Higher the current to be interrupted causes larger the gas pressure developed inside the chamber. Hence, better the arc quenching. But this put a limit on the design of the arc chamber for mechanical stresses. With use of better insulating material for the arc chamber, such as glass fiber, reinforced synthetic resin, etc., the minimum oil circuit breaker are able to meet easily the increased fault level of the system. Now we see the principle of arc quenching in minimum oil circuit breaker. So this is the minimum oil circuit breaker. This is cross blast minimum oil circuit breaker. In minimum oil circuit breaker, the arc drawn across the current carrying contact is contained inside the arcing chamber. Hence, the hydrogen formed by the vaporized oil is trapped inside the chamber. As the contact continues to move after its certain travel, an exit vent becomes available for exhausting the trapped house hydrogen gas. There are two different types of arcing chamber available. In terms of venting are provided in the arcing chamber, one is axial venting and other is radial venting. In axial venting, gases, mostly hydrogen, produced due to vaporization of oil and decomposition of oil during arc will sweep the arc in axial or longitudinal direction. Now we will see the principle of operation. With the axial venting chamber, the moving contact has just been separated and arc is initiated in the minimum oil circuit breaker. The ionized gas around the arc sweep away through upper vent and cold oil enter into the arcing chamber through the lower vent in axial direction. As soon as the moving contact tip crosses the lower vent opening, the final arc quenching in oil minimum oil circuit breaker occurs. The cold oil occupies the gap between the fixed contact and the moving contact, and the minimum oil circuit breaker finally comes into open position. Whereas in case of radial venting or cross blast, the gases, mostly the hydrogen, sees the arc in radial or transverse direction. In axial venting, generate high pressure, high gas pressure, and hence has high dielectric strength. So it is mainly used for interrupting low current at higher voltage. On the other hand, radial venting produces relatively low gas pressure and hence low dielectric strength, so it can be used for low voltage and high current, low voltage and high current interruption. Many times the combination of both is used in minimum oil circuit breaker so that the chamber is equally efficient to interrupt low current as well as high current. This type of circuit breakers are available up to 8000 MVA. Now we see the advantages of vacuum the next is vacuum circuit breaker. So a vacuum circuit breaker is such kind of circuit breaker where the arc quenching takes place in vacuum. The technology is suitable for mainly medium voltage application. For higher voltage, vacuum technology has been developed but not commercially viable. The operation of opening and closing of current carrying contact and associated arc interruption take place in a vacuum chamber in the breaker, which is called vacuum interrupter. The vacuum interrupter consists of a steel arc chamber in the center, symmetrically arranged ceramic insulator. The vacuum pressure inside a vacuum interrupter is normally maintained at 10⁻⁶ bar. The material used for current carrying contact plays an important role in the performance of vacuum circuit breaker. CuCr is the most ideal material for vacuum circuit breaker contact. Vacuum interrupter technology was first introduced in 1960, but still it is a developing technology. So as the time goes, the size of the vacuum interrupter is being reduced from its earlier size. So different technical developments in this field of engineering. Now the vacuum circuit breaker, the contact geometry is also improving with time, but contact of early days is gradually changes from spiral shape, cup shape and axial magnetic field contact. The vacuum circuit breaker is today recognized as the most reliable current interruption technology for the medium voltage switchgear. So there are certain advantages of vacuum circuit breaker. The service life of vacuum circuit breaker is much longer as compared to the other types of circuit breaker. There is no chance of fire hazard as oil circuit breaker. It is much environmental friendly than SF6 circuit breaker. Besides of the construction of vacuum circuit breaker is much user friendly, require replacement of the vacuum interrupter is much more convenient. Now the operation of vacuum circuit breaker. The main aim of circuit breaker is to quench arc during current zero crossing by establishing high dielectric strength in between the contact, so that re-establishment of arc after current zero becomes possible. The dielectric strength of vacuum is 8 times greater than air. Dielectric strength of vacuum is 8 times greater than that of the air and 4 times greater than the SF6 gauge. So this high dielectric strength make it possible to quench a vacuum arc within very small contact gap. For short contact gap, low contact mass and no compression of medium, the drive energy required in vacuum circuit breaker is minimum. When two face-to-face contact areas are just being separated to each other, they do not be separated instantly. Contact area on the contact face is being reduced and ultimately comes to a point, and then they are finally detached. Although this happens, in a fraction of microsecond, but it is affect at this instant of D touching of contact in the vacuum
like this.
This is fixed contact, moving contact. So at the instant of D touching of contact in the vacuum, the current through the contact concentrated on the last contact point on the contact surface and make a hot spot. Here they will make a hot spot. As it is vacuum, the matter on the contact surface is easily vaporized due to that hot spot and create conducting medium on the arc path. Then the arc will be initiated and continue until the next current zero. At the current zero, the arc, vacuum arc is extinguished and the conducting material, conducting metal vapor is recondensed on the contact surface. At this point, the contacts are already separated, hence there is no question of re-vaporization of the contact surface for the next cycle of current. That means the arc cannot be re-established again. In this way, arc circuit breaker prevents the re-establishment of arc by producing high dielectric strength in the contact gap after current zero. There are two types of arc shapes for interrupting current up to 10 kiloampere. The arc remains diffused at the form of vapor discharge and cover the entire contact surface, and above 10 kiloampere the diffused arc is constricted considerably by its own magnetic field and its contact. The phenomena gives rise of overheating of contact at its center. In order to prevent this, the design of contact should be such that the arc does not remain stationary but keeps traveling from its own magnetic field. Especially designed contact shapes for vacuum circuit breaker make the constructed stationary arc travel around the surface of the contact and thereby causing minimum and uniform contact erosion. So by this way, arc is being extinguished in vacuum circuit breaker.